I really want to go to space. So I made my own astronaut training program because nobody else would have me. I'm like a pet up for adoption and I just decided to adopt myself. I've already made sure that I won't throw up and I won't go crazy in confined spaces, but there's still this thing weighing me down. The biggest downer on planet Earth. Freaking gravity! So we rented a sensory deprivation tank. Basically, it's this pod filled with 1,000 pounds of Epsom salts. You can float in it and experience what it's like to be weightless. You ready for this? My jumpsuit gear is like an onion. This is like layers upon layers.
This is the closest I've ever been to climbing back into my mom's uterus. This is so weird. I don't dare to put my head down. Oh, I don't know what that could do. It kind of makes my teeth hurt. Do you mind? Sorry.
Donald Trump is president, and I'm opting out. Hashtag space boom. I mean, hashtag send Simone to space. So we went to San Jose because I got a ticket to the Vomit Comet. I had to get up at 6 a.m., so I was fucking excited. A zero-G flight is an airplane that does parabolas, so it goes up really fast and then down really fast, so you get to experience what it's like to be weightless. I was really freaking nervous about it because a lot of people do throw up, and if you throw up, you have to get back in your seat for the rest of the flight. So basically, it'd be the most expensive vomit of your life. Unless you, like, threw up into somebody's Gucci bag. For each parabola, you get about 30 seconds of weightlessness, and we did 15 of them, so I got about 7.5 minutes of glorious weightlessness. So without further ado, here's some footage of me having the freaking time of my life. So I was supposed to narrate this as it went, but I could get no intelligent commentary out of myself.
I have no idea what to say!
Yeah, that's about it. As the airplane is going up, you're laying down on your back, and first you're getting heavier and heavier and heavier, but then you're getting lighter and lighter and lighter until you just float up. It was really like flying, and your body doesn't really know what to do. Like, your instinct is to just pedal, which is terribly ineffective.
Oh my god!
They threw out some water, and we got to catch some candy. So yeah, here we are. Also, I cut my hair because I felt that I wanted to look even more like one of the Hanson brothers. But motherfuckers. So going on the zero-G flight was huge. Like, I've been wanting to do it for such a long time, and it was the wildest thing I've ever done. Like, it was like nothing I've ever experienced before. And also, this is the last episode of DIY Astronaut. Thank you so much to Google's Making and Science team for giving me a budget for this project.
But now I've run out of money, so we're back to filming on my iPhone. How's this level of production value for you?
Get used to it! Get used to it!
Also, huge thanks to Adam Isaac, who helped film and edit DIY Astronaut, and Scott Laurie, who produced it and did production coordination. They were the best paid friends a woman could have. By the way, I set up a store and now you can buy the Astronaut T-Shirt. So if you feel that you want to look both offensive and stupid at the same time, just click on the link in the description and get one of these beauties. It's a solid T-shirt. And I don't know about you, but I feel fully ready to go to space. So Richard Branson, I'm just waiting for you to call me.
Call me.
It might go faster if we all tweet him.
Shameless plug! I have no shame in my space game! Send Simone to space!
Not Simone Biles. I mean, she seems nice and all, but Simone Yatch, Gertz, whatever. Simone Dryheave. Simone Queef on a Yoga Ball. Simone Can't Pronounce Yacht. That girl! Me! I mean, otherwise I'll just have to build myself a rocket, and I don't think any of us wants me to do that. It'd make for an interesting tombstone though, so that's something. Anyway, check out the DIY Astronaut T-shirt, and I'll talk to you soon. Thanks for watching DIY Astronaut. I had so much fun! Oh gosh, you're gonna hate me.